family, even for the family reunion. Steps and doing that is planned well in advance for the reunion because you got to get hotels and everything. You just can't want to throw a reunion at the last, you know, a month in advance to try to get 80 hotel rooms because it's not going to fly. Listen to ideas of other family members because they have a lot to bring to the table. You might want to get a team together to track down as many family members as possible because we want everybody to participate. And then the family members that you get in touch with, they'll call other family members so we can get everybody together. This is your first time having a reunion. And like I said, track down volunteers. Make a master list months ahead. A master list of names and addresses because you want to have like a mailing list. So if you want to update the whole family on what's going to happen, how much money you got to pay for the hotel or picnic or whatever, we need you to help out. We just want to have everybody's name and addresses, and I guess now emails, so we can keep everybody up to point on what's going on. Look through old pictures and letters because you might find old relatives that you just forgot about. Oh, Uncle, what's his name? And then you can just write him or whatever. Use older family members as sources of information because older family members know everything about the reunion. I mean, everything about your family. They can tell you a little history about it. Something that might be going wrong with you may have happened to a distant relative of yours, you know, and they're very knowledgeable sources to go to. Make a family file, names, addresses, telephone numbers, basically just to keep a list of family members so you can never be confused on what's his number, what's his name, or whatever. Make a family tree. I made my first family tree when I was in first grade, and that was quite an experience because I knew what a first cousin, second cousin, third cousin was, how's this person related to me or whatever, so I'm very knowledgeable now because my mom started me out early with family trees and such. Special interests, you might have cousins or uncles that play basketball or CEO of companies or finished college or got master's degrees, you know, because you might have advice or questions you might want to ask relatives, or who better to ask than your relatives. Involve all your relatives, organize teams or branches for different tasks because not one person can do a whole, you know, job for one family. So the way my family does it, we have like 8 cities. Each city we have a branch. They have, you know, chairman, vice chairman, secretary, recording secretary, and they have meetings like once a month, so each branch gets back to the national, and then we start planning for the reunion. So just some of the responsibilities include finances, food, hotels, family activities, creating a family tree of history, that's very important, and forming branches and elect officers. And like my family, we usually change officers every 3 years, so we want to keep it fresh. Planning the event. Decide on a date well in advance. That's critical because of hotels, banquets, or parks, or whatever, because you have a whole family, you can't just go into a park and just barbecue or whatever. You gotta get permits, and all this, some of this requires at least a year's notice. How long the reunion should be? Usually people have their reunions 3 days. I've been to one, it was just one afternoon, just one picnic. Everybody got together, met each other, whatever. The cost of the reunion, you just might want to total up everything and try to figure out who's going to pay what, and might want to ask everybody to buy a t-shirt. T-shirt might cost $20. It might only be worth $2, but you're kind of helping towards the financial responsibility of the reunion. Also, pick a site. I'm from Chicago. We come to East St. Louis. We usually have a reunion in Connersville, and we had a picnic in Frank Holton Park, and then the people from East St. Louis decide, you know, what we're going to do while we're here. Hotels. We usually don't stay at motels because motels, they don't have a lobby or a common meeting area, so we like to use the Holiday Inn in Connersville, so you can go down to the lobby, you see all your relatives, hey, hug them and all that stuff. You haven't seen them in a while, go hang out, responsibility because usually you have to get a caterer, whether you're gonna do a banquet or a picnic. If you're trying to feed about 1,000 family members, you might wanna, you know, get on that real early. That all comes from deciding on the date. Enjoying yourselves, that's the main point of the family. Plan icebreakers. One year we had a family trivia where we had a whole bunch of questions and we tried to let some of the younger generation ask the question. Like, we had a family member that was on The Price is Right, somebody won a car from a game show, who went to this university, you know, different things like that. And then it kind of gets people to socialize and everything. Videotape the reunion for memories. Like, you might have, you know, a softball game, y'all have, you know, fun out, y'all just videotaping the picnic, interviewing different relatives. That's always fun. The family history, like I said, is very critical because if you don't know where you came from, you can't go anywhere. You know what I'm saying? You always have to reflect on the past to get where you're going or to make the road that you get into much easier. Family tree is something that I think everybody who has ever done a family tree here?
Who has?
I mean, for people that haven't did it, you know, it's like a good way to track your family down, you know, because I found cousins. I never knew they were cousins. I had a girl that went to that go to school with me now that I didn't know was my cousin. Establish a tradition. Keep in touch with all the family members. Basically, I put this here because after the family reunion is over, you don't want to just fall out. You want to keep in touch with emails and phone numbers and Christmas cards or whatever. Start a family newsletter, just updating what's happening in the family. Like, somebody might have graduated from kindergarten, somebody might have had a baby or whatever. We do that in my family too. Plan the next reunion right away. And my family, usually on that Sunday, the last day of the reunion, we have a meeting to decide what city is going to be in. And then, you know, the people from that city get together probably the next month or two and try to get the dates and the hotels really quick so we can get that out the way and start on that next reunion. Don't ever let it stop because family reunions are fun, it's very educational, and it's something I look forward to every year.